Hello and welcome back to my channel Learn with Nikhil. In this video, I'm going to show you the MCQs on the topic Introduction to Robotics. If you want to know the explanation for this MCQs, you can refer to my video lectures. It's there in the description box below. So let's begin. MCQ 1. Robot is derived from Czech word A. Robota, B. Robota, C. Robota, or D. Robota. And the right answer is Robota. Next question. Twisting joint is a subtype of which joint? Linear joint, orthogonal joint, rotary joint, or revolute joint. So as you know, twisting joint is a type of an rotary joint. Next, in orthogonal joint, the axis of input link and output link is parallel to each other, perpendicular to each other, symmetrical to each other, or linked to each other. So in orthogonal joint, the input axis and the output axis are perpendicular to each other. Next question, what is the another name for end effector? A. Link, B. Joint, C. Controller, or D. Gripper. So, end effector is also called as gripper. Which type of joint is this? So, you have to see the image, and as this image, A. Linear joint, B. Orthogonal joint, C. Revolute joint, or D. Rotary joint. And the answer is orthogonal joint. So in orthogonal joint, the input axis and the output axis, input axis and the output axis are perpendicular to each other. Next, an end effector is attached to the dash of the robot. A. Elbow, B. Arm, C. Manipulator, or D. Wrist. So end effector is the end part of the robot and it is always attached to wrist. Which type of joint is this? So see the image. A. Linear joint, B. Orthogonal joint, C. Revolute joint, or D. Rotary joint. And this is linear joint as the input and the output axis are parallel to each other and this is sliding like this. So, the sliding joint is a type of a linear joint. Next question, identify the joint. So, this is the joint given. Is it a linear joint, orthogonal joint, revolute joint, or rotational joint? So, this is a rotational joint as this is the axis of rotation. This is the Z axis of rotation. This is the input and the output link. Next question, in prismatic joint, joint offset is dash and joint angle is dash. So in prismatic joint, is it variable fixed, fixed variable, fixed fixed, or variable variable? So in prismatic joint, joint offset is variable and joint angle is fixed. Next question, in revolute joint, joint offset is dash and joint angle is dash. So now in revolute joint, joint offset is fixed and joint angle is variable. So it is the opposite of prismatic joint. Next, cylindrical joint has dash DOF 1, 2, 3, or 4. So in cylindrical joint, you have 2 degrees of freedom. Next, a spatial manipulator has dash degrees of freedom. Is it 2, 4, 6, or 8? So in a spatial manipulator, it has 6 degrees of freedom. If you want to know the explanation of this, you can visit my YouTube videos lectures on chapter number 1. I have also provided the link in the description box below. Next question, a planar manipulator has dash DOF 2, 1, 3, or 6. And the answer is 3. Next, in robotics, accuracy is measured in millimeters, centimeters, picometers, or kilometers. And the accuracy is always measured in millimeters. A robot designed with Cartesian coordinate system has dash joints. 2 rotational, 1 linear, 3 linear, 3 rotational, or 2 linear and 1 rotational. So in Cartesian coordinate, It has three linear joint. It can be PPP or SSS. That is, P is prismatic or sliding, sliding, sliding. Next question. A robot designed with cylindrical coordinate system has dash joints. Two rotational, one linear, three rotational, or two linear and one rotational. And for cylindrical coordinate system, it has two linear and one rotational joint. Next, a robot designed with spherical coordinate system has dash joints. Two rotational, one linear, three rotational, or two linear and one rotational. And the answer is two rotational and one linear. Next, a robot designed with revolute coordinate system. Same options, and the answer is three rotational. So you have to remember all this. Any question can be asked. Towards the next question, what safety practice should be observed before powering a robot mechanism on? So this is the general question on robot safety measures. A. Check robot operator knowledge. B. Check that the robot is plugged in. C. Ensure robot movement area is clear. Or D. Check robot software is okay. So the answer is ensure that the robot movement area is clear. Next, when planning industrial robot installation, what primary safety item should be addressed? To keep productivity high, so robot can move properly, robot can injure humans and damage the robot, or robot might get damaged. So robots can injure humans and damage the robots. Next, least count of a measuring device can be compared to repeatability of a robot, accuracy of the robot, resolution of the robot, or controllability of the robot. And the answer for the least count of measuring devices, resolution of the robot. Next, in manufacturing units, a robot can help in A. Hard automation, B. Fixed automation, C. Flexible automation, or D. Piece production. And the answer is flexible automation. Next question. Unimation, the first robotic company, was started by Victor Scheinman, B. Carol Capek, C. Isaac Asimov, or D. Joseph Eisenberg. And the answer is Joseph Eisenberg. Next question. Asimo humanoid robot was developed by, Asimo is the name of the humanoid robot. It was developed by Honda, Unimation, Odetics, or NASA. And the answer is Honda. Next question. Ball and socket joint or spherical joint used in robotic consists of three rotary joints, two rotary and one translating joint, one rotary and one translating joint, or four rotary joints. And the answer is three rotary joints. This is the similar question which we have come earlier. A. Redundant planar manipulator may have 1 DOF, 2 DOF, 3 DOF, or 4 DOF. So redundant planar manipulator is nothing but more degrees of freedom than the required one. So for planar manipulator, we require 3 degrees of freedom. So redundant is nothing but the excess degrees of freedom. So more is 4 DOF. So 4 DOF is known to be redundant for planar manipulator. Next, an under-actuated spatial manipulator will have 6 DOF, 7 DOF, 8 DOF, or 5 DOF. So as you know, in spatial manipulator, we require 6 DOF. And under-actuated is nothing but anything less than the 6 DOF will be under-actuated spatial manipulator. So in this, we have less than 6 is nothing but 5. So the answer will be 5 DOF. Spot welding is an example of point-to-point task, continuous path task, neither point-to-point task or continuous path, or combined point-to-point task or continuous point task. So spot welding is an example of point-to-point task. Which of the following statements is true regarding spherical coordinate system? Two linear, one rotary, again the similar type of question. So the answer here is one linear and two rotary movements. Workspace of a cylindrical coordinate robot is the volume swept between two partial spheres, a cylindrical annular space, a cuboid, or a conical space. So workspace is nothing but the area covered by the cylindrical robot. And the answer is a cylindrical annular space. Next, two different types of linear joints are prismatic and sliding, revolute and twisting, prismatic and twisting, sliding and revolute. So the linear types of joints are prismatic and sliding. So the answer is prismatic and sliding joints, that is A. Next question, the major type of manipulator joints that can be seen in industrial robots are cylindrical, planar, rotational or screw joints. And the answer is rotational joints. Next, how many degrees of freedom the human thumb, index and the middle finger respectively have? Answer is 5, 4, 4, 4, 4, 4, 3, 4, 5 or 5, 3, 3. So the degrees of freedom for the human thumb is 5 and rest all the fingers are 4. So the answer is 5, 4, 4. So in the question, even if you get index, ring finger, any finger, that will have 4 degrees of freedom, and the only human thumb has an extra degree of freedom, so it comes to 5. Next, the sliding joints are called prismatic joint, revolute joint, lower pair joint or rotational joint, and the answer is prismatic joint.